Your side hot seat again joining us tonight, Phyllis Landrieu and Pat Cooper with the Early Childhood and Family Learning Center Foundation. Well, where is the governor and state lawmakers on making the right decision for education, Ms. Landrieu?
Well, last year the legislature passed unanimously a bill sponsored by Senator Ann Duplessis that establishes universal early childhood education in Louisiana over 5 years. Unfortunately, this year it was not in the governor's budget and it didn't get funded the first year out of the box. So that's a very big problem, and we're already warned that the next two budgets are really going to be drastic. What has to happen is our legislature and our state and our citizens are responsible for making sure that the priorities in Louisiana are set in the order of first come children and their education, second the economic development of the state. Now, there's a greater impact on economic development by educating children, by education, especially early childhood education, than by any other thing that we can invest in.
Dr. Cooper, that wouldn't seem to be a very difficult selling point. What's the problem?
Well, the problem is that in the last 40 years, we've been in education reform of some sort, and it's all been driven by book companies and test companies and folks that are trying to make money. And those of us that have been in education for all this time, and this is my 38th year, you begin to understand that it's not the needs of children necessarily that are addressed, it's the needs of the people who are running education reform, and that's the businesses and the industries that have propped up around it. So part of our problem is we've got to get educators to get information to legislators that's based on hard, fast data, and that's what our project's going to do. We know right now that 90% of the kids that start kindergarten in New Orleans that are tested are in the bottom quartile, 90%. So what that means is that we've got to be able to show that data as it changes so that when we increase that number, our children, 100% of them are going to start kindergarten ready to learn. We're going to show that that's going to make a difference in crime, in graduation, in economic opportunity.
We talked about the governor and the state lawmakers. Why is this such a hard sell for local leaders?
It's just such a big job, Norman, and it's maybe not a sexy issue. People are kind of tired of talking about education reform because we've had so many that have rolled over and rolled over. I've met with many people in the business community in the last few weeks, and they tell me that we've invested in education reform many times, but we're at the wrong level, and so it's our job, and thank you for this opportunity, to help to educate the public that early childhood education for our children, who are the inner city children in particular, must be in place if we are ever going to change education.
You know, I was at a forum during marking the progress of the 4 years of after Hurricane Katrina, and someone said that we are maintaining an outdated doctrine of community. Are we maintaining an outdated doctrine
Absolutely.
Of education?
Absolutely. In education, definitely. We are still operating in the 19th and 20th centuries. We're now in a new millennium and a new century, and it's time for New Orleans to take the lead with the institution of this early childhood center and the plans to expand it throughout the city. We could be a national model in early childhood education. Dr. Cooper has put together a comprehensive plan that addresses all the children's and the families' needs, which is a key ingredient. And he has reached out to many people in the community and begun to develop a very strong collaborative that is going to make this work.
Dr. Cooper, when is this going to get off the ground?
We plan to open doors January the 4th. Construction for the Mahalia Jackson School, which is one of the old Orleans Parish schools, and this is an Orleans Parish school project, that particular facility was not being used, and so we began to renovate it. That renovation should be complete by December 1st, and we should be moved in by January the 4th.
Is this something that has to work, Ms. Landrieu?
It has to work. It will work. We've put it together thoroughly. We have a sound foundation, and a lot of people are beginning to come to the realization that this is the only thing that will work.
Well, thanks to both of you for being here.
Thank you.
That concludes this week's segment of The Hot Seat. Now back to the news desk.
Thank you.